गुड मॉर्निंग, लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द लेक्चर. सो वी वर ऑन
मॉर्निंग सर।
एम्प्लॉयबिलिटी स्केल्स. गुड मॉर्निंग अमित. सो वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट एम्प्लॉयबिलिटी स्किल्स एंड द टॉपिक दैट वी हैव टू स्टार्ट विद टुडे इज कॉमन पर्सनैलिटी डिसऑर्डर्स. Personality disorders, they involve long-term patterns of thoughts and behaviors that are unhealthy and rigid. So, see, personality disorder का मतलब है कि your thoughts, your behavior is not good. It is unhealthy and it is rigid. Rigid means it's not difficult. It's difficult to change, right? So, it's a way of thinking that deviates from worldly expectations. मतलब जो normal लोगों की सोच है उसे अलग तरीके से सोचना, right? And it's a way of thinking also, it's way of feeling also, and way of behaving also, right? And it's a long term process. काफी देर तक रहती हैं ऐसी problems. इसमें कैटेगरीज हैं. वन इज सस्पिशियसनेस, दैट पीपल फॉलिंग अंडर दिस कैटेगरी ऑलवेज मिसट्रस्ट अदर्स. यू आर सस्पिशियस अबाउट समथिंग, राइट? फॉर एग्जांपल, वर्षा इज अ हाउस मेकर एंड मेड हैज बीन वर्किंग हियर फॉर 2 इयर्स. डिस्पाउट ऑफ हैविंग सीसीटीवी कैमरा इंस्टॉल्ड एट द होम, वर्षा इज ऑलवेज सस्पिशियस अबाउट द मेड. सो सी, द ट्रस्ट फैक्टर इज नॉट देयर. लेडी इज suspicious about that worker, although the workers were working from the last 2 years, and moreover cameras are there, so still certain suspicion is there in her mind. So this kind of category comes in, it's a kind of category of personality disorder, right? And basically what happens is, now whenever such kind of things are there, then people are stressed, they are more stressed. Paranoid personality disorder, this is the order in disorder in which it is categorized by distrust of others, right? So you are not trustful to your family members, you are not trusting on your family members, you are not trusting on your friends or even partners, right? So this is also one kind of problem. Then schizoid personality disorder, it refers to the natural tendency to direct attention towards one inner life away from the external world. So the person is more concentrating more on its inner life, right? So not concentrating on the normal life that a person lives, right? Such kind of person, they are detached, aloof, right? अकेले रहते हैं ऐसे लोग. दे आर प्रोन टू इंट्रोस्पेक्शन एंड फैंटेसी. फैंटेसी मतलब ख्याली, ख्याल, ख्यालों में खोए रहना. इंट्रोस्पेक्शन, दे कीप ऑन इंट्रोस्पेक्ट, दे आर कीप ऑन चेकिंग देमसेल्फ, राइट? राइट, खुद से ही सोचना, दैट इज इंट्रोस्पेक्शन. द पर्सन शोज लिटिल इंटरेस्ट इन फॉर्मल पर्सनल रिलेशनशिप्स एंड इमोशनली द पर्सन इज कोल्ड. मतलब डजंट अफेक्ट इमोशन, डजंट अफेक्ट सच काइंड ऑफ पर्सन, right? So this is also one category. Then schizotypal is another disorder. People with this kind of disorder believes they can influence others or events with their thoughts. So they think that they are genius, right? So they, such people, they just think that they can influence others, right? And such kind of people often misinterpret behaviors, right? So they could not judge the people in a better way, and this cause some coming kind of inappropriate emotional response, right? And this is also one category. Then cluster B is a second kind of disorder. It is related to emotionals and impulsive nature. And this disorder, unstable mood and behavior is there. Mood is not stable, person is not stable, the behavior is not stable, right? And again, relationships are not strong in this case. Unstable relationships are there. Person is not connected to the family, friends, and all. Right? Emotionally, person is very instable. Sometimes he feels very low. Sometimes he feels really aggressive. Right? For example, Sunny is a student in high school. Whenever he gets low mark, he is depressed, and then he fights with the friends, and he also does not try to learn from mistakes. Parents and teachers have tried talking to him, but he feels angry, worthless, and shouts at them. So this is one kind of category of disorder, right? This is emotional disorder. Then antisocial personality disorder is one category under this. So such people, they disregard social rules and obligations. So social rules means whatever rituals are there, whatever social bounding is there, usko disregard karte hain. They don't follow them, right? They are irritating and aggressive, and they tend to lack guilt and fail to learn from the experience, right? So they don't want to learn anything. They are rigid with the thoughts and all, right? And such people, they used to lie, or they steal or abuse others, right? And people may be, they also may get addicted to the drugs and alcohol also, right? Just because they try to be away from the others, right? Then borderline personality disorder, the people with this kind of disorder essentially lack a sense of self-worth. So they don't have confidence, right? Experience feelings of emptiness and fear of abandonment. So they always feel that they are abandoned, they are free, they are unko akela chhod diya gaya, right? So they feel like that. There's a pattern of instability, violent outburst, and impulsive behavior, right? Violent outburst means they are always violent. They fight with people, and they always give suicidal threats to others, right? So they, matlab, they show that they will harm themselves, right? So this acts as self-harm is one common point in this, right? So basically, they have difficulty in dealing with the stressful events. So whenever stress is there, so they are not able to cope up with that stress. They are not able to come out of that stress. Then is histrionic personality disorder. People with the disorder frequently try to gain more attention by being overly dramatic. Right? So they try to be very dramatic so that they can gain the attention of various people. Right? So they try to gain attention of others. Right? So this is also one kind of disorder. They are very sensitive to criticism and disapproval. So if anybody tries to disapprove them or criticize them, they are very sensitive. And that sensitivity can lead to troubles. Right? And they are very easily influenced by others. Others may easily influence them, right? Then there's a narcissistic personality disorder. People with disorder believe that they are more important than others. They feel that they are more important, right? So this leads to depression. Whenever there is lack of empathy for others, when other people do not give proper attention to them, so they feel depressed, and they go into depression, right? Then is category C, the cluster C is anxiousness. So such people, they are have strong feeling of worry, anxiety, and fear, right? So this basically affects their daily routine. For example, Shikha is an elderly woman. She stays with her family. She has a habit of washing hands at least 20 minutes a day, 20 times a day. even after washing the hands, she feels that they are not clean and continues rubbing and washing them. And she neither talks to her grandchildren nor does she participate in any family activity. So she is in a kind of anxiousness or in a kind of worry that that she may prone to some, if she doesn't wash her hand, then she may get some kind of disease. So thoda dar rehta hai aise logon ko, right? So ye, because of that only they never participates in their social life. They does not talk to their family members. They does not play with the children or grandchildren also. So ये एक कैटेगरी है एंग्शियसनेस की जो दैट लीड्स टू सम काइंड ऑफ पर्सनालिटी डिसऑर्डर. अवॉइडेंट पर्सनालिटी डिसऑर्डर, पीपल विद दिस डिसऑर्डर आर सोशली इनेप्ट, अनअपीलिंग और इनफीरियर. दे फील इनफीरियर, दे आर लोअर देन अदर्स. इनफीरियोरिटी कॉम्प्लेक्स इज देयर, राइट? एंड दे कॉन्स्टेंटली फियर बीइंग एम्बैरेस्ड. सो दे थॉट कि बाकी लोग उनको एम्बैरेस करेंगे भाई. Right, they with other people may criticize them, they may reject them. So that's the feeling that the people have. So that's why they avoid meeting others, often experience feeling of inadequacy, inferiority. So they always feel that they are inferior, they are unattractive, they are not as par with others. Fine. So ek category ye ho gayi, then dependent personality disorder. People with this disorder are characterized by lack of self confidence. They don't have self confidence in them and an extra need to look after, right? So they need a lot of help in making decisions and surrender important life decisions to the care of others. So what happens is, like, they are not able to decide themselves, right? And they are always dependent on others, right? That's why the name dependent is given. They are always dependent on others. Even the important decisions of their life are not taken by them. They are always dependent on others for the decisions, right? So they are not able to take the decisions properly. Heavily dependent on others, right? For even their physical needs, for emotional needs, for so they avoid being alone, right? So they always feel that they are dependent on others, and then that's the problem they have. Next is obsessive compulsive personality disorder. People with such disorders strongly stick to rules and regulations. Jo pakke hain bhai, mujhe aise hi karna hai, right? So they can be characterized by a general pattern of excessive concern with orderliness, perfectionism, and attention to details. So such people, they are always thinking that everything should be perfect, everything should be in order, right? And they always go into every detail of everything, right? They feel extremely uncomfortable when unable to achieve perfection. Jab perfection nahi dikhti hai, to wo uncomfortable feel karte hai, right? So they may even neglect personal relationships to focus on the projects that they are. They are not bothering about their personal relationship, their family members, their children, wife, and other. So the important people in the life, which are their family members, unko neglect karke, they are focusing on the project. The project is more important. The work is more important than their relationship for them. Right, so these are some kind of disorders that people have. Now the next thing is steps to overcome the personality, whatever personality disorders we have, how do we overcome them? The first thing and the most important thing is talk to someone. Whenever you feel depressed, you feel that you come under any of these categories, so talk to someone. Share your feelings. So that sharing of feelings is important, because you will get an idea what to do in case you are not able to decide anything, right? You should share your ideas with others. You should talk to your family members, your friends and all, right? Always look after your physical health. healthy body can help you maintain a healthy mind. If you are physically fit, that means your mind is also fit, right? Healthy mind comes to those people who are physically fit also. Physically, they are good in by health, right? So you should always maintain your health. Build confidence in your ability to handle situations, difficult situations. So always build confidence on yourself. Have confidence that whatever you are saying, whatever you're deciding, it is all, you can handle any kind of situation, any kind of problem, right? Engage in hobbies. This part is again very important, because sometimes we don't find the right answer for the problems that we are facing, the situations that we are facing. So to engage yourself into your hobbies will help you to overcome all those things, right? You will not your mind will be sharp enough for you. Your mind will focus on only the important things. So that relaxes your mind. When you when you're involved in a hobby, like if you like to play a certain game, or if your hobby is to dance, if your hobby is to painting, do painting, or if you have a tendency to listen to music. So that these kind of things help us to relax our mind. So if any kind of complexity is there, any kind of problematic situation is there, you people will feel more comfortable, more relaxed, and it will be easy for you to make decisions, right? So hobbies are very important. So we all should have hobbies. We all should engage ourselves in hobbies, right? So they have therapeutic effect. So therapy ka kaam karta hai ek tarike se, right? Then stay positive by choosing words like challenges instead of problems, right? हम लोग बहुत सारे लोग ऐसे बात करते हैं, यार मेरी लाइफ में बड़ी प्रॉब्लम है, बहुत प्रॉब्लम है, ये प्रॉब्लम आ गई, वो प्रॉब्लम आ गई. This should not be the word. So you should say that these are challenges, right? They are not problems. They are challenges that you have to face, and then you can overcome those challenges. Always think like that, right? So be positive. Don't go into negative effect of everything. Everything that we come across has both positive and negative effects, right? So if you think positively, you will be relaxed, and if you think negatively, you will be in trouble, right? So always be positive, think of the better things, and you'll always result in a better situation, right? So these are some of the things related to your personality skills, right? The chapter 2 is all over here. In the next unit we have ICT skills. Now, in this chapter, we'll cover up all important terms and all important things that are used in digital technology, right? It covers up communication tools. It covers up different kind of terms used in digital technology. Then you'll also learn about spreadsheets, presentation softwares like that, right? Now, in session 1, we have, we'll talk about spreadsheets. Although most of the things are all covered, I'll just go through it once. I'll not go into details, because all these things we have already covered up, right? Most of the things are covered up in 11th class only, right? We have done that before. So let's just see this, what all things are there. What is spreadsheet? Spreadsheet is a kind of software where we can create data in the form of rows and columns, right? It's electronic document. And what is the use of a spreadsheet? That we can do, we can manage the data in a systematic way and then do calculations in them with help of certain functions, right? So that's the important part of spreadsheet software. Right, so like this is the table that you want to manage. You have a total quantity, then quantity sold, quantity left, cost, selling price, and now you want to calculate what is the total amount you have spent, what is the profit you have gone, got for different items like this. So it will be easy if you do this in Excel, in any kind of spreadsheet software, and then you just apply certain functions, certain formulas here to calculate all those things. So that helps us to calculate the things in a better way and an easier way, right? It takes very less time to do it. So a lot of spreadsheet softwares are there in the market. Microsoft Excel is the common one. Then LibreOffice Calc is there. Google Sheets are there. OpenOffice Calc is there. So a lot of softwares are there. These are free tools. This is the proprietary software, which is a paid software, you can say. Now this book covers up LibreOffice Calc. Right? It's just like OpenOffice that we have done in 11th class. How do we start? We all know how to start. So type LibreOffice Calc in the search bar or go to the start button and then go to the LibreOffice option in all programs. And then you can just click on that icon that is created. Or there's sometimes we have a shortcut on the desktop. Double click the shortcut to open it. Then the contents of a spreadsheet, we have rows and columns. Rows are horizontal arrangement of cells, and columns are the vertical arrangement of cells. These are columns, these are rows. One intersection of these rows and columns is called as a cell. Right? And every cell has a point in the corner, which is called as cell pointer. And that pointer has a different use. It can be used to copy a value. It can be used to copy a formula. Right? On the top, we have a formula bar where we can enter the formula. Then we have a name box here where the current address of the cell is shown. Like if the cell is in column number A and row number 1, so the address will be A1, right? Then there's a term called as worksheet. One worksheet is collection of cells in the form of grid. Grid is lines that intersect each other and makes rectangles, right? And in one file, you'll feel that there are a number of sheets, sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3. Likewise, we can create multiple sheets. And then collection of these sheets is called as a workbook, right? When you open up a file, so the name of the file that you save, that whole thing is saved in the form of a workbook, and we can add more number of sheets from here, right? So one workbook contains a number of worksheets. Then basic operations in spreadsheet. As you see, I told you, this is a cell. And how do we enter a data? You just click on the cell, type the thing directly. So whatever you type, it will be, that will enter the cell, right? Or you can type in the formula bar. So whatever you type there, it will also show there in the cell, right? Then whenever we type the things in one cell, if it is text means it is in alphabetic form. If some word is typed, some sentence is typed, so text is always aligned to the right side of the cell, and the number that you type is always aligned to the left side of the cell. This is important question for exam also. The text is right aligned and number is always left aligned by default. So you can change the orientation, you can change the alignment later on. Then to enter a formula, we always start with equal to symbol, then put the formula that you want to add. Like if you want to add two numbers, so write the two numbers with plus sign between and press enter. So that will enter the, that will give you the sum of the both the numbers, right? Sorry. So then is editing a cell data. Types of data we have, we can type alphabets, text, that is, we can also enter numbers, we can also enter formula, right? Now, if some word is written already in the cell, how do you change it? One way is double click on the cell, right? So the moment you double click, the cursor line will start blinking. Then you can move on with your arrow keys on from the keyboard, or you can press backspace to remove certain part of that text, and then you can change it or rewrite it, right? Or if you want to change it entirely, you just single click, give a single click, not double click, गिव ए सिंगल क्लिक ऑन द सेल स्टार्ट टाइपिंग, तो जो पुराना लिखा हुआ उसको हटा के उसकी जगह पे नया टेक्स्ट आ जाएगा, ओवर राइट कर देता है, राइट। और सेकेंड वे इज क्लिक ऑन द सेल, गो टू द फॉर्मूला बार, फॉर्मूला बार पे क्लिक करो, वहां से आप चेंजेस कर दो, राइट। सो दिस इज हाउ वी कैन चेंज, राइट। एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कंप्लीटली चेंज इट, देन क्लिक ऑन द सेल, सिंगल क्लिक, एंड देन स्टार्ट टाइपिंग स्ट्रेट अवे। टू डिलीट, जस्ट प्रेस डिलीट की फ्रॉम द कीबोर्ड टू डिलीट एवरीथिंग, और डबल क्लिक एंड देन प्रेस बैक स्पेस, सिंगल क्लिक एंड डिलीट, डबल क्लिक एंड बैक स्पेस। Selecting multiple cells, that is simple. You just do it with the mouse pointer, drag it down, drag your mouse from the cell from where you want to start to the cell where you want to end, right? The cell which is currently clicked is called as an active cell, and the group of cells that you have selected, multiple cells that you have selected, are called as cell ranges, right? अच्छा, हाउ डू वी सेलेक्ट मल्टीपल सेल्स? इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सेलेक्ट द इंटायर रो, देन क्लिक ऑन द रो नंबर। इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सेलेक्ट द इंटायर कॉलम, क्लिक ऑन द कॉलम हेडर ऑन द टॉप। और इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सेलेक्ट द इंटायर शीट, देन क्लिक ऑन दिस ऑप्शन इन बिटवीन ए एंड वन, राइट। द एरिया बिटवीन ए एंड वन, अबव वन एंड टू द राइट ऑफ ए, यू क्लिक ऑन दिस एरिया, इट विल सेलेक्ट एंटायर शीट, राइट। एंड द थर्ड वे इज इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सेलेक्ट सम पर्टिकुलर सेल्स, तो आप उस सेल पे जाओ, ड्रैग करो, और वेर एवर यू वॉन्ट टू गो, गो टू दैट पर्टिकुलर प्लेस एंड देन दैट पर्टिकुलर सेल, एंड देन लीव द बटन, राइट। एंड टू सेलेक्ट मल्टीपल डेटा, लाइक इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सेलेक्ट मल्टीपल रोज, सो फर्स्टली सेलेक्ट, क्लिक ऑन दिस थ्री, लाइक इन दिस एग्जाम्पल, क्लिक ऑन दिस रो नंबर थ्री, एंड नाउ यू ऑल्सो वॉन्ट टू सेलेक्ट रो नंबर फाइव, then press the control button, then click on this 5, this is row number 5, so row header, so this will select both the options, right? Then how do we save? This we know that, go to file menu and then click on save, and whenever you save the file, save the file saved is saved in the extension ods, right? Give a name and then you can save. Close and exit, we know that. How do we close? Close will close the current file, current workbook, not the software. And if you click on exit, everything will be closed. Opening, go to file and open, select for the file, browse for the file, and click on open button. Printing, go to file, click on print, and then when you click on print, a print dialog box opens up where you have to select the name of the printer, right? It will also show you the preview on the right side. Select the name of the printer, number of copies you want to print, and then how many sheets you want to print. You want the printout of all the sheets in that workbook, or only selected sheet, or the selected cells. So ye kuch ranges select karne ke option hai. All sheets matlab us file ke andar maan lo teen sheets bani hui hai, so it will print all the three sheets, everything in those three sheets. If you go with selected sheets, so it will print only the sheet which is opened, not other sheets. And if you go with selected cells, so whatever you have selected on the screen in one worksheet, only that portion will be printed, not beyond that, right? And if you want certain particular pages to be printed, then click on this pages and then you can give the page number here, right? And see, on Excel, it is difficult to make out where is the page. So that you can see in the preview here, right? So when you have multiple pages, you'll find the pages preview. So from here, you go to next button. This is next button and previous button. So keep on checking. From here, you can see the page that you want to print. So give that page number here, right? And click OK to print. Fine. So this is how we do this. Working with data and formatting text. Now, how do we add certain values, like if you want to add the numbers given here. So one way is you put this equal to sign and then put the numbers with plus in between and press enter at the end. Don't forget to press enter. If you try to click anywhere else, so wo cell address jo hai wo pick kar leta hai. इसलिए क्या करना है, इक्वल टू लिखो, नंबर्स प्लस नंबर सेकंड नंबर प्लस थर्ड नंबर एंड प्रेस एंटर, राइट? सो यू विल गेट द सम ओवर हियर. नाउ वी कैन आल्सो फाइंड द सम विद द हेल्प ऑफ सेल एड्रेसेस इन प्लेस ऑफ नंबर्स. वी कैन गिव सेल एड्रेसेस ऑफ द नंबर लाइक द 73, 89, 78. वी वांट द सम ऑफ दीज थ्री वैल्यूज, बट आई डोंट वांट टू राइट द नंबर्स. इंस्टेड ऑफ नंबर्स आई वांट टू गिव द सेल एड्रेस, बिकॉज in case a value change, like say Rohit got 73 marks in English and later on we found out it was wrong, his marks were 83. So now if we have taken the previous formula, this one, to yahan pe mujhe formula mein bhi changes karna padenge. To yahan pe agar aap cell address lete ho, to then whatever changes are made here will automatically get reflected into the formula that we have entered. So uske liye kya karna hai, 73 ka address batao kya hai, B2, then next match ka C2 and then D2. So we'll put equal to B2 plus C2 plus D2. So in place of numbers, we have given cell addresses. So whatever the values there in these cell addresses, that will be added. And then you press enter again, you will get the total, right? So this is the second way. Then is using mouse to select values. We can also select value with the help of mouse. So instead of typing B2, C2 and D2, what you can do is you put equal to and then click on B2 first. You'll see automatically that clicked on this cell 66, right? So you'll automatically see B2 will be added there. Then use the plus sign, type plus, and then click on the next cell. This will also automatically add C2. Then put plus again and then click on 78. So that will automatically add D2. So you just click on those cells, their cell addresses are picked up automatically. ठीक है, तो आपको address type करने की जरूरत नहीं है. Equal to type करो, cell पे click करो, उसका address automatically add हो जाएगा. And in the end, you press enter. Right? Another way to find sum is using a sum function, right? So in this case, we have only three numbers, right? So it's easy for us to type the cell addresses or type the value straight away. But if we have, let's say we have a long list of values, there are 100 values. Now it will be difficult for us to type all those 100 values or their cell addresses, right? So typing is difficult. For that, we can use a function to find the sum. Now how do we use this? Put equal to, write sum, open bracket, then give the address of the first cell from where you want to start, put a colon, and then put the address of the last cell that you want to end with, right? So, and then close the bracket with the closing bracket and press enter, right? Or one way is you can type, like if you can type equal to sum, bracket open, you want to start from, let's say B2 to D2. So we'll type B2 colon means two dots, and then type D2, put the closing bracket and press enter, right? Or you just put, इसका दूसरा तरीका यह है कि इक्वल टू सम ब्रैकेट ओपन, क्लिक ऑन दिस सेल B2, देन पुट कोलन सिंबल टू डॉट्स एंड देन क्लिक ऑन द लास्ट सेल, देन पुट क्लोजिंग ब्रैकेट एंड प्रेस एंटर. सो दिस विल ऑटोमेटिकली पिक अप द सेल एड्रेसेस, राइट? सो वी आर स्पेसिफाइंग अ रेंज ऑफ सेल्स हियर. सो व्हाटएवर रेंज वी हैव गिवन, उस रेंज के अंदर जितने सेल्स वैल्यूज हैं सबका सम हो जाएगा, राइट? Then is how do we copy a formula or a move a formula. To copy a formula, just right click on the cell where the formula has been written. So right click and click on copy, or you can do is control C from the keyboard to copy it, right? And go to the new location, click on right click and paste, or you can press Control V to paste the value, right? And if you want to move it from one place to another, then in place of copy, you do cut. Right click, cut, or plus Control X. So, and go to the new location, click on right click and paste, or press Control V from the keyboard to paste the value. Fine. So this is how we can copy and move a formula. Copy can be done with the help of Control C and copy option, and moving can be done with the help of cut and Control X option. Right? Then we also have certain formatting features. This you can go through yourself. Text font size and all this, we know how to format the text. Alignment of the text, right? The text can be aligned in four ways basically. Left align, right align, center align, and then justify alignment, right? Highlighting of text can be done, right? You can highlight the text, which say text ka jo jaise, this is highlighting that I have done, right? To make text bold, Control B is the option, or we have a bold button on the top to make it bold. Control U is used to put underline, or we have here A is written, uske niche line hai, so this will add up underline option. And Control I is for italics option, so this will move a tilt the text to right side a bit, right? So that's all from this session. So we'll talk about advanced features in the next class, right? So just go through all these functions, practice them, and then if you have doubts and all, you can come up. Although we have done this in 11th, all these things, right? So